Then I go, maybe they're just soulmates.
Right.
And their souls
maybe
are
you're just a matchmaker. Puerto Rican matchmaker.
Clearly.
Can you not?
That's right, because Daddy's a dancer, and he dances a lot.
Did I say hot? I meant not.
Erroneous! Erroneous on both counts!
Like, what goes on?
When the world is darker than I can understand, when nothing turns out the way I planned, when the sky turns gray and there's no end in sight, when I can't sleep through the lonely night, I turn to you like a flower leading towards the sun. I turn to you, 'cause you're the only one who can turn me around when I'm upside down. I turn to you.
Boom. And thank you. That was great. Welcome to another episode of the What Goes On podcast. I am your host, Juan Antonio, a.k.a. Antoine 9000, a.k.a. Captain Passion. Some people call me King Thick. And I'm here once again, another installment with my co-host,
Amanda Marie,
and we're back, and we are absolutely fired up, and we are throbbing with electricity and
anticipation.
That's the word I was looking for.
Okay.
Guys, thanks for being with us again here today. I kind of just want to start real quick before we get into really anything.
Okay.
Guys, the last episode was a fucking hit. Let's just say that. Outpaced every other episode we've done.
Because they love the gossip.
We had the same amount of views that we have in 6 days, literally in the first 14 hours. Crushed it. It was awesome. Thank you, guys. We love you. And if you're a new listener, you know, keep it coming, because we're going to keep it coming. So keep coming back. You keep knocking on the door, and we will answer, and we will have a fresh pecan pie for you, waiting for you to come see us. Also, share. Tag and, you know, spread the good word of the What Goes On podcast. Yeah. So we're back. We had a week off.
We did.
It's been a week. I know you don't know, but it's been over a week. And I've missed being with the viewers and the listeners. I miss being with you here in this environment. And I'm just glad we're back.
I wish I could do it more. I always feel like it's always me. I know, and I'm sorry.
It is, but it's fine. But also, I don't know if you have noticed, if it's our listeners, but we both have our sunglasses on, which means we are drinking.
It's a beautiful Sunday day. It really is. The weather outside, I went outside before and I said,
it's so nice out.
It's magical.
Summer just goes, I'm not gonna hang out anymore.
No, but
summer just completely ended, and now it's perfect.
It's
sweater weather. Shout out. Oh, speaking of sweaters, shout out to our baby fucking girl, Ruth Bader Ginsburg. I know you're like, who's that old fucking white bitch? No.
Okay.
Number one, this is a fucking a VGW. A very good white. She's a good white.
Okay.
She's down
she's
for
good.
The fucking cause.
Yeah, she's a woman.
We love her. And she's also a woman. This is probably why she's a good white.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, baby girl. You're probably saying, oh, he dies. He had no. Okay. Listen, baby. I've had this fucking sweater for about a year and a half now, so don't fucking come at me like,
he
pretending to care. Listen, boo-boo, I've been had this shit, motherfucker. You heard? I've been on that motherfucking shit, okay? So don't even fucking test me with that nonsense, okay? You can miss me with that.
Oh my God, I can't.
Know what I mean, bro?
You better stop.
So yeah, she passed away.
I know,
no, it's gonna be great, because now that she passed, you know, we could have her seat filled with someone who's gonna overturn everything we've ever fought for.
No, I don't think
but
they
that's
would.
Great.
I honestly really don't think they would.
But it's fun because this isn't a politics podcast,
but
so we're gonna skip it for a second because I will go into a fucking rage.
I know.
And I don't want to do it because spirits are high. We just start off with an absolute I would
electric
say,
song.
Electric rendition.
I love that song. That's a really special song.
It's an amazing song. And also, you know, people don't realize who sings that.
Spice Girls.
It's Sporty Spice. It's Mel C, whatever. Girls. But it's Sporty Spice. So good. The best voice. Delight. Her and Scary Spice, the only good ones literally on the docket, you know?
Well, I love Posh. She made it.
She's also very hot, but go ahead. What were you going to say? Sorry, I fucking cut you off.
No, it's okay. No, that song just reminds me of an old friend of mine. We used to sing that song a lot. It was very, like, symbolic for his
pre-game,
life.
Like a pregame kind of fucking rip.
That and just, like, it was, like, a cute little song between me and him.
Right.
He was, like, battling drug addiction.
I know who you're talking about.
And we became close, and he said for a while that, like, I helped him, like, get clean or whatever.
Wait, who are you talking about?
Where you have to definitely bleep that out. I don't want to do that.
I will 100% believe that, but is that it?
Yeah.
Or is it the other one?
No.
Okay.
I don't even know who the other one would be.
His brother's name is... That will also be bleeped. I'll bleep it. It's funny, because then it's like a beep. Like,
I know.
Well,
it is what it is.
Anyway.
No, so I recently saw someone sent a video to me of him. Looks horrible. I can say that, right?
You say whatever you want. Really, this is our space.
Yeah. So, it just reminds me of that, and I'm...
And what?
I can't.
Are you going to elaborate?
So when you said names, I didn't want to say names.
I'll fucking bleep the names out. Who gives a flying fuck?
So that's
I told my old chemistry teacher I would fucking eat him and his fucking children. I said his wife was a fucking bitch. I don't even know if he has a wife.
Well, I don't like to do that either way, but that's
it will be
caught.
It will be bleeped. It's fine.
It's a good song. I love it because of that. Yeah, and at the time, a really good friend of mine came out to me about being gay.
Your best friend?
Yes.
Right.
For like many years throughout high school, after my 21st birthday, like all of that.
So it was metaphoric, I turned to you, so it was like one of those, like, hi, Bendy.
Yeah.
Right.
So we're obviously not friends anymore. Him, you know, I used to date his brother.
Here it is.
Yes.
No, wait.
That was
okay.
What the video
was.
Okay.
Okay, here it is. Let me set this up for you. I didn't think, obviously we saw this podcast and me and Amanda are like, oh, we're fucking real, like, we're fucking whatever, we're fucking cool, fucking Puerto Ricans, yeah. But there were a couple of things where I'm like, okay, we're clearly not going to talk about this.
Are we not going to bring it up?
Clearly not going to talk about that.
But then it's like we become filtered, but then it's like, we're not our true
We're not playing fucking
selves.
Games, though, here's the thing,
I
you
know,
understand?
I know.
We have these things, these fucking $10 mics, and it's just our duty to give the people the fucking real. So what Amanda is trying unsuccessfully to segue into is she told me off air what she is willing to talk about, and it is great. I'm very happy we're talking about it, and it's going to be amazing, and stay tuned because it's fun.
So I had a best friend.
Yes.
In high school, growing up, my ride or die.
Yes.
He was obviously gay. Many years of us growing up, he just never came out about it. It was kind of like the unspoken.
Still gay?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Well, because we all know that it's a choice. Right.
No, so he wasn't. He actually came out to mommy before he came out to us.
He came out to me outside those steps right
there. Yeah, it was
there.
A lot of it came here.
Yeah,
and I was really good friends with him and... that whole group of people.
When did you start being friends with him?
Middle school, so probably like 7th or 8th grade.
Got you,
what
okay.
is that, 2001?
Mm-hmm.
So we're talking, oh wow, like 20 years. Oh my God, you're talking like 19, 18 years ago. Either
so
way.
So it's your best friend for a
Many
very long
years,
time.
Yeah.
Okay.
So after a while, he ends up coming out to me, which was like moving, you know, your best friend comes
it's
out
nice,
to you, whatever.
It's sweet, you feel like you're trusted. That's
yeah.
like,
I was
your
so
best
happy because
but...
I felt like he felt... Relieved.
I mean, everyone,
like,
everyone,
we all knew
me.
Like,
knew
stop.
I mean,
and
we
loved
we
you
doing?
Either way, whatever.
Obviously.
So his older brother always knew him. He used to date someone else I knew, whatever.
Right.
And we all end up relinking because I think I hadn't talked to this person for a couple of years and we relinked and they were actually doing like drugs, like hardcore
drugs.
Yeah.
Not
so,
like fucking drugs. We're talking drugs.
Right. So I'm kind of like, well, you probably shouldn't be doing that. And like, let's hang out. And like, let's... Because I had broken up with a boyfriend
now, when
that
you,
I was
when
with.
You first met your best friend who's gay, his brother, did you immediately go, oh, that's a cute human being?
Yeah. Isn't that weird? That? Because that was so many years before.
We weren't really that close to that
because
time,
I
so I didn't even know any of this.
I met this person when I was in sixth grade.
Oh, gotcha. So now you relink, you're older, and you go, oh, that's a cute human.
Oh, yeah, I remember
him. Okay, so there you go.
Right,
go
so yeah. So either way, we started dating, we were good. We lived together for a short period of time. And
so you and the best friend's brother start dating.
Yeah.
All right. So how long are you dating for?
3-4 years.
3-4 years. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You end up moving in together.
Uh-huh.
In Petrogi.
Yeah.
Right. You have a cat.
Love that apartment. Yes.
I remember you had a fucking cat.
We did.
What was his name? Rascal?
And everyone, you know what it was?
Lightning.
Here it is.
Bandit.
Everyone hated me because I bailed, which I thought was such bullshit.
Bailed on what?
The relationship.
Oh, okay, we'll get into it. Go
so ahead. His brother, who's my best friend, which I understand, I complicate things because now I'm dating your brother, but I always made it very clear that you're my best friend and I love you.
That comes first, right.
That's separate. And I feel like I was close enough to his family, like, you know, his parents were like, everyone, it was fine. I've been around for years. So I was with him, we were good, but then I find out that he's doing drugs again. This was before I was a social worker. Because if I was a social worker and dating somebody, now all of a sudden I'm like, oh, I can fix you. Like, we're going to go to counseling. We're going to get you a sponsor. All that. Back then, all I knew was that, what do you need? I'll help you.
Right.
And I got
drugs.
This. No, I got this. It's not bad. I promise. I'm like, okay. So we go on. And then I see text messages in the phone about picking up, this and that. He's hanging out with a group of friends who they're like snorting things out of my bathroom.
Oh, my God. This bedroom?
My apartment.
Your apartment.
Our apartment.
Got you.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're dating this guy. You find out he's doing drugs again.
And now, three years later,
you're in a tough situation because not only are you dating, it's a brother of your best friend for years.
Yeah, but it's almost like past that because it's like 3 years later we live together, like it's fine. Then I find out you're doing drugs and I'm kind of like, at this point in my life, I hadn't really experimented with drugs like that because I was only maybe like, I don't know, I was younger, maybe like 22, 23. That was 10 years ago. And he was, like, doing things I just felt were, like, no, like, we're not having that. And I was worried about, we're going to live together and have a house, and then you're going to tell me you're not paying the mortgage because you're heavily addicted to drugs? Like, it was, like, these weird things, and I was, like...
makes sense.
And it just, one day he came up to me and was, like, do you want to do coke? And I had never done coke in my life, so I'm kind of, like... And at that moment, my heart kind of just shattered, and I realized this relationship just simply isn't going to work. It's just not. Yeah. I can't. So, and I cried. I looked at him and I cried because I knew at that moment that I was out of love with him. And let me tell you, I loved him. I really did.
You had a place together.
I really genuinely loved him.
You had a fur baby. Shout out white people.
No, but like I always felt excited to see him. And that was like 3 and 4 years into our relationship already. And to still feel like that, I really did love him. But I think I came to a place in the relationship where I was like, I was scared. I don't know how to deal with someone who has a drug issue. I already tried. I would go to counseling. I'd be your sponsor, whatever I needed to do. But you didn't want to do that. And I didn't feel confident moving forward without something like that in place.
Right.
So we broke up. So obviously tensions changed a little bit between me and
you broke up.
Yeah.
Okay.
I remember you
moved back here, right?
It's actually funny because... There were people that were instrumental into being my support of leaving that relationship. But when I left the relationship, those people stayed friends with that group. After, you kind of poisoned my mind to almost break up with him and tell me how bad it is. Like, oh, I think he's doing drugs and would be little snippy things. And like, oh, you know, like, and oh, would say, like, little things to me. And that's honestly how I ended up finding out because I didn't know. I know now what it looks like for you to be in drugs. I know what the telltale signs are. Right. So they're the ones that pointed it out to me. But they ended up staying friends with them. And
the people were in your head like, oh, my God, he's doing drugs and shit. And now all of a sudden, now that you leave, they stayed with him, even though they were instrumental in you making the clean cut.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So that's what makes me look back, and it's kind of like, what was happening? Was the situation...
Well, let's not look back yet. Let's keep going forward.
So
you break up after the drug revelation. I just can't do this anymore. The drugs.
I'm scared.
Right. Let's move on.
I was scared.
So you break up, you move back home, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Go.
And then this is when I saw a big shift in that best friend really hanging out a lot with our aunt. They became really, really close friends because she used to hang out with us like here and there. Whatever,
right. Here's
somehow...
let me tell a little background on our aunt, the artist formerly known as Titi. So our aunt is young-ish to be not as young as us clearly, but she was always a cool aunt, very fun. Always, we would stay at her house to grow up, whatever. But she was, like, closer, not as close, but, closer to your age. So she'd hang, and you guys would go out.
She used to hang out with Lynette for a while.
Right.
They rocked hard, heavy, because we were still young.
Right.
We were still really young, so they were close in age. And then they rocked hard.
Then our sister grew up, and then like, I grew up a little family. Bit more. Right. So then this our aunt just started hanging out with you and your friends, and those friends happened to be your gay best friend,
and
the guy that you were in a relationship with, because they're obviously brothers. Mm-hmm. So that's the quote unquote friend group.
Right.
It's our aunt. It's Amanda. It is the gay best friend and the gay best friend's brother, who was Amanda's boyfriend and then soon to be ex-boyfriend, right? So that's like the core group. I remember you guys would always drink together, go out. I would always go, like, everyone's having so much fun. Like, I remember, like, the very fun. So that's the core friend group. So then you break up. And then I guess a part of you is like, okay, well, clearly my aunt is not going to hang out with them anymore because...
No, that was never... At least not that.
I know, but I'm saying, like, in your brain, you would assume.
It was very weird. It was very, very weird.
So I would assume, you know, once you break up with someone, maybe you hang out with, you know, the gay best friend, but you keep hanging out with the ex-boyfriend, right? So then how does that play out?
I don't know, people were kind of, like, shady with me. I don't know, like, they didn't want to hang out with me. I feel like they were kind of, like... shading me, and I was like, what's going on?
Some time passes by, you realize people are being shady with you.
Yeah, like, they don't want to hang out with me. People really aren't my friends. Like, even my aunt, I'm like, what's up? Like, and she's always hanging out with... hanging out with that person and his brother, and I'm kind of just like, oh, okay, I guess that makes sense. So I move on with my life. I'm working, and I end up dating other people and whatnot, and I hear that I was out with someone who I was dating, and I ran into our aunt's ex. And I give him a hug. We take a picture. We're in patch hug. I'm like, how are you? What's going on? And he had said something about, I don't even know how it came up. About maybe them breaking up. I'm like, well, you know how she is. She's up this one's butt, talking about the gay brother. And he was like, I don't know about that one, but maybe the other one, the brother. And I'm like, what do you mean she's up his butt?
Your
like,
ex.
What do you mean? Yeah, my ex. I'm like, he's like, yeah, because I saw text messages of them, and I'm like, whoa, like, wait, are you saying that my aunt is actually, like, doing my ex-boyfriend? I start crying, right? I'm on Main Street in Padgett, and I'm crying, and he's like, Amanda, I'm so sorry, I didn't know you still have feelings for him. And I'm like, no, it's not even that I have feelings for him. I go, this is my aunt, like, what do you mean? It has nothing to do with him. Like, my heart was just like, what are you even talking about? To the point where I think my defense mechanism... No. And this is true story. My defense mechanism was to shut it off. So I shut this off. Like, I told everyone. I told everyone in our family. I said, can you believe this? This is what I'm hearing.
So can I break it down the way I just heard?
Yeah.
Okay, so, you know, they break up that. Now the friend group and Amanda are distant, you know? So now... You know, now Amanda is in the middle of Patchogue. You know,
drunk.
She's face to face with her aunt's ex, and now her aunt's ex is telling Amanda, I don't think you should be worried that, you know, she's hanging with your best friend. I think you should be worried that she's hanging out with your ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
That's the fucking issue. So now, once that happened, right, now the rumblings are starting. Now Amanda's like, oh, maybe now it makes sense. Now it makes sense that, you know, they're being weird, right?
Yeah.
Now pieces are coming together. Yeah. So now, you know, discreetly under the surface, the family's starting to whisper. You know, people are thinking, no.
Yeah.
Didi blank? Really? She raised all of us. How can she do something like that?
It was tragic.
And then a little bit something like, maybe they're just still friends. Maybe that friend group is still friends. They exiled you, which is fucked up, but maybe it's just, No harm, no foul, you know? So that's, you know, in my brain, I remember thinking the situation, oh, maybe they're, like, okay, it's fucked up that they're still hanging out, you know, drinking, having fun, but, you know, it's not that bad. But then, after that conversation, we start thinking, oh, can our aunt really be talking to her niece's ex-boyfriend that she lived with for 4 years?
You know what's even more fucked up?
Well, don't, you're very good at spoiling surprise, so let me set it up.
No, about our uncle?
No.
Okay.
So here's how it unfolds. This is how it unfolds to the family. Let's just take it over here, okay? So we have a little cousin who goes to school in this school district. So what her mom would do, she would drop her off at our aunt's house, who was in the morning at the school district, and she'd wait there and she'd go on the bus.
Do her hair, get her ready, give her breakfast.
And now she's dropping off at, you know, 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning, right? So now our little cousin, you know, is slowly starting to divulge that she's seeing, when she's going there in the morning to our aunt's house, she's seeing men's shoes at the top of the stairs. You understand? So our little cousin getting dropped off every day, and she keeps seeing like a man's pair of shoes. No men live in the house. It's our aunt and our little cousin. She doesn't wear men's shoes, right? So, you know, So she sees the men's shoes. So now we're thinking, holy fuck. The shoes. And now we're like, you know, because it's our aunt, we're starting to think, you know, are we being too judgmental? It could be another guy's. It could be another guy's shoes. But now that we have that information about her ex-boyfriend, now we're like, wait, are those his shoes?
In the room. There's a in the man room. In the room every time.
Right. And it ends up being so now when she gets there in the morning, she realizes that there's someone in the room who our aunt will not reveal. That person is secluded in the bedroom. The aunt sometimes comes out, but the person wearing those shoes does not come out.
Ever.
So, you except know, once. Part of us is like, oh, maybe it's a booty call, which much respect, you know, whatever. Do what you gotta do. But a little bit of us is like, holy fuck, are the rumors true? You know, a little bit of us right. like, is
you
this...
You don't want to believe it
is
for
this,
so long.
Is this her niece's ex-boyfriend, right?
Yeah.
So the day of reckoning. I forget what day of the week it was, but, you know, our little cousin gets dropped off. She walks up the stairs, right, as she normally would do. She walks up the stairs and she looks... Mind you, this girl is young. She looks and our aunt is naked at the kitchen table with Amanda's ex-boyfriend and the brother.
I don't know if the brother was there.
Anyway, they were naked drinking.
I don't think the brother was there.
So apparently, their drunken stupor lasted so long, it had to be about 6 in the morning, that when our cousin was going to school the next day, happens to see this. So our cousin, being the very intelligent person, doesn't really want to make a scene, so apparently she goes back downstairs and makes it pretend
what
like she doesn't
an
see it.
Intelligent stomp, little girl.
Stomps on the stairs to re-enter so they hear her. So here you walk up quietly. Oh my god. She walks back down, stomps so they know.
They wake up.
They go, oh fuck. She hears running to the room.
Yeah.
She goes up and then they play off and nothing happens.
Right.
So now that little girl knows this.
Right.
Now it's like her brain's got to be fucking roosting.
It was.
You know what
it
I'm
was
saying?
A shitty situation.
So then I don't
yeah.
think we know at the time, but then what really confirmed is that now these rumors are swirling, right? Yeah. So Amanda one day is here and she goes, you know what? I'm just going to go check something real quick.
Yeah.
And this was like probably, it was a day of the week where there was no drinking going on. It was a work day.
It was the middle of the week. It was the day before my birthday.
Day before your birthday. So May 5th. Mm-hmm. Amanda goes, I'm going to go take a drive. She drives by our aunt's apartment building. And whose car is out front? None other than her ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
And that's when it becomes clear.
It was one of those...
Punchline! Our aunt is banging her niece's ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
And that's what we've been trying to say for the past 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you think... Everyone listening, if you think your life's fucked up, welcome to our world.
And it's fine now.
But is it, though?
It is. So, they've been dating for years and
so
years.
So, once that happened, she has been completely exiled from her family.
Yes, I think she had a conversation with
no
mom.
No one talks to
and
our mom flipped out on her. How can you do this? Yada, yada, yada.
I don't even know. I don't even want to. That's not even about that. But
it doesn't even matter. That's just
it
the
is
story.
Now. Because now, I got a text message yesterday.
Uh-huh.
And they got married. So,
spoiler alert!
Congratulations! They're married now, and you know what? I look at it and I'm like, you know what? Maybe I was that vessel, and they're soulmates. Do you think? And I brought them together because I was like, do I get a finder's fee or? Because then I'm telling myself, I go, maybe.
You're just maybe you're just a matchmaker.
But then I go, maybe they're just soulmates,
right?
And their souls.
Maybe
are
you're just a matchmaker. Puerto Rican matchmaker.
Clearly. Dreams. Relationship goals.
Just in case that past 10 minutes was disjointed, let me give it to you in 13 seconds.
Congratulations.
Our aunt
married.
Is now married to Amanda's ex-boyfriend.
Which is fine.
Do we understand what I'm telling you? This is our life. You can't write this. You can't script it. No. And it is what it
but
is.
You know what? You want to know what a sucker I am and how soft I've become over the years? Is that somebody sent me the video of the wedding. I didn't play like the vows and all that, but I saw her like walking up to about to marry him, and she was half in tears. And like for a second, I actually thought about knowing her my whole young life. And like when she was about to cry, I almost felt, and I really was like, aw. Like in this weird way. Right, and I was like, oh my God.
Now, let me give you a little bit more background. Like, because here's the deal. Our aunt, I know, you know, some white people are like, oh, I'm close to my cousin. You see him 3 times a year.
Yeah.
In a Puerto Rican family,
she raised a lot of our kids.
She raised many children. Every child, she was there. We would stay summers.
So close.
Every summer, we would go there every day.
Yeah.
She raised all the cousins. She was a great aunt. She was fucking awesome, fun.
Yeah.
Made sure we were fed. She made sure we were dressed nicely.
Yeah.
Made sure everyone was clean.
Yeah.
Like she was. I remember. She used to tell me, "Clip your fingernails. Females don't like that."
She
literally saved our grandmother's life, which is even worse. Our grandmother needed a liver transplant.
So she gave half of it.
Right? A couple people said no.
But honestly,
yeah. No. A couple people said no.
Yeah, I know, but she did that
which is fine.
For our uncle than she did for my grandma.
Doesn't matter what you did.
Which is fine.
Doesn't matter. She literally saved our grandmother's life by giving half of her liver to
our
grandmother.
No, I'll never take that away from her.
Our grandmother is in great health now. We have all these years because of her.
That only brings it more to the point where
it's even
worse. That was so amazing to do, and that I wished that we would have had a relationship throughout our entire lives, because what a beautiful thing to always celebrate and thank you for, because we've had parties for her thanking her multiple times, and I feel I always thought that it would be that forever.
Right.
And it wasn't, and you know, she's gone into her own new
holy
matrimony.
We had a whole party in a hall celebration.
Yeah.
Thanking
our
aunt for saving.
No, but everyone knows how it is, but now it's just weird. Now you've made the situation awkward to the point where we really can't have a relationship with you considering the circumstances.
Awkward? That's betrayal.
It was betrayal. It's not betrayal anymore. It's not betrayal.
Awkward's like sending a naked pic to your fucking.
No, I wouldn't say, because I'm like.
Awkward?
No, I used to.
It's betrayal.
Yeah.
It's betrayal. We had a party that you, I mean, and it's just, you know.
I know.
And that's just what you gotta look forward to. In this family, it's just a bunch of nonsense.
But that's why I almost was like, maybe I was like the soulmate maker.
You're the matchmaker. So, you know what? So maybe this could be, you can look at it two ways. Maybe this is a story of ultimate betrayal and despair. Or it could be you were the catalyst to a beautiful, you know, relationship. Right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. We don't know what it is, but it's one of those.
Right.
And it is what it is. I'm okay with it.
So that's our family. If you have any stories you guys want to tell, you can send it. But, you know, everyone's happy. And maybe that's just the fucking bullet you got to bite sometimes to find true happiness, you know? Maybe sometimes you have to live in a world where your aunt marries your ex-boyfriend.
Yep, it's just...
You know, maybe that's just, you know, who knows?
That's just in the stars for you.
You know, sometimes life, you know, sometimes you hit the lotto, sometimes your aunt marries your ex-boyfriend.
Right.
You know, to each his own. Whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
And so on and so forth. So that was, that was fun, you know? I hope you enjoyed that. But that's what we're dealing with. That's what we're dealing with. And we're moving
today,
along.
I did go outside, okay?
What a beautiful day today is.
It's fucking gorgeous out.
It's what weather?
No, it is, and I love it, because I'm sitting here. I go
it's
outside.
Beautiful.
And no, I go outside, right?
It's
and
beautiful.
The sun is beaming on me, right? And I have this sweater
the
on.
The sun is out. The sky is blue. There are no clouds to spoil the view. But it's raining. Raining in
it's
my
not raining.
Heart.
No rain.
Okay, sorry. I like that song.
What I'm saying is that I love so much about New York is that, okay, don't get me wrong, we pay obscene amount of taxes, the houses are overpriced, we know that, okay, no one cares.
Whatever.
But the weather, the sweater weather, I'm here for it, because we enjoy all four seasons to the max. It's like the summer came, it was hot, we're going to the beach, are we doing fireworks, whatever that looks like, okay?
Right.
Then it's getting chilly, and we're putting the sweaters on, and we're getting turkeys.
The leaves are turning.
And we're going pumpkin pink.
It snows when it's supposed to.
Yes, and you're going to have your apple cider,
you know what it took me a
donuts and coffee.
You know what took me a long time to realize?
Candy.
There's human beings who live in this country who have never seen the ocean.
Yeah, that's...
They go like, hey, y'all, you want to go to the lake? It's like, what?
No, but even that's okay. No. I don't want to be... No.
I use the accent intentionally, okay?
Do you think the ocean means
is a big deal? Difference? Yeah. They go to the lake as if it's some sort of, like, it's Cancun. They go to the lake and they go, oh, yeah,
What makes us even enjoy Cancun? The fact that it's literally out into the ocean?
No, no, my point is that they're so, it's the middle of the country is so full of despair and distraught that they see a small body of water and they lose their minds. They can't even believe it. We have a lake, Ronkonkoma, and people die there. That's the difference. Our lakes, when we see a lake, we go, oh, is that haunted?
Right.
You know, we see a lake, we go, am I going to die in that lake? And then they see a lake, they go, this is paradise. You know? This is paradise. They're walking on pebbles and rocks and, like, glass.
Oh, my God.
And they go, this is paradise. We see a lake, we go, is this my last breath on this earth? Because the lake is haunted.
No, because we do live in such a bubble. But the one thing that I'm saying that I do like about it, so now I come up, it's fucking gorgeous. Jonathan, I'm wearing a little sweater, right?
Gorgeous.
And I'm... The sun is beaming on me, and I don't want to kill myself.
I'm not going to say it.
I don't want to kill myself because the sun's not that hot. We're getting that breeze.
That's what
and
it
you're
is.
Chilling, you're moving.
That's the thing about New York is like every time you're about to kill yourself, the seasons change.
No, it's beautiful.
Like, it's so cold, let me kill myself. Oh, wait, there's a flower.
No.
And it's like, I'm so sick of this rain. It's like, oh my God, there's the sun.
No, it is.
And then it's like, it's so fucking hot. It's like, oh my God, the leaves are changing. So every point you're about to kill yourself,
and then, but even think about
a season change.
Think about Christmas. What other area of the country can you have a true Christmas
and a true Halloween
to you.
And a true summer.
Thank you.
Beaches, summer.
Long Island.
Right.
Fall time.
Where's the tree? All the pictures of the tree. What tree are we going to? Is it in Ohio?
No.
Is it in California?
Definitely not.
Is it in Maine?
No.
Is it in Cape Cod? Where's the tree?
It's in New York. And it's cold and you wear your clothes.
Who has the best beaches?
Who
has the best beaches?
It's New York.
New York. Thank you.
In the summer.
Where are all the coastal elites? Montauk.
No, we have a lot of country out there where we can do that whole fall
everything.
Scene.
Where are the places
we can make snowmans?
Snowmen, but it's fine.
Snowman.
Where are the places in the earth can you make a snowman?
Do all that. No. Yeah.
Right? Can you make a snowman? Can you grow corn? Or strawberries, whatever.
Strawberries, sunflowers.
Can you run into a meth addict bum on the streets?
That might happen.
In New York.
But you can get all of that.
And you can also go pumpkin picking. We have everything you need. So basically, this podcast is sponsored by the state of New York. You know what I mean? It's just a great place to live. Is it expensive? Yes.
Can
you might get shot in certain towns?
Because I went outside today and I said, what a fucking treat. It's beautiful outside. No, I said, I can sit. It was really refreshing. We could really consider doing an episode out there because it would really change my energy.
You have everything you need.
It's gorgeous.
You go to the North Shore. And it's like you want to be rich. There's a pot for you.
Well,
do you want to deal with the Suffolk police and maybe they shoot you a couple times? Yes, you can do that as well. Can you go out to Montauk and be bougie? Yes. Can you go to Fire Island and be gay? Yes. Can you go upstate and pretend to get an education? Yes.
Oh my God, I love it.
You know what I mean? Niagara Falls, Appalachian Mountains.
Niagara Falls is amazing.
The Great Lakes. You know. Hilary Duff. I think she lives here.
Does she?
I don't know. I met her one time in my Outback. She
you
went.
Love it.
She came in and took a shit. Shout out Outback and Holbrook.
Did she?
She did. I have a picture with her. Check out my Instagram.
Oh my God.
So that's what's happening. So New York's great.
I like
our
the seasons of New York.
What?
Oh my God. I love the seasons of New York. It's not. It's like, and it's, she's not.
No, we're off. We're off. It was just a quick.
Okay. No, because I just want to say, like, at one point of it, I almost, like, looked at it and said, aw. Yeah. I don't like. You
but
know,
here's the good news. The good news is that we have more ants, or titis as we call it.
No, but I just want to make sure that like. We
oh,
still...
speaking of the word titi, okay, I propose sorry to you. Okay, I know we live in a fucking white area and everything. Everyone's fucking white, and everyone hates fucking fucking a blue line. Cool guy. Anyway, so I'm in school, and you know, we had groups, different groups, and it's a reading group. So one group would read one book, and you'd go, and the whole year you'd rotate books that you read. So now I'm like, oh my God, yeah, like my titi said this one time. And they're like, all my kids are like, oh, what? Your titi? I'm like, yeah, my titi said like this. They're like, what? They're dying, hilarious.
No,
they're like, what is a titi? I'm like, my mom's sister. It's like, you mean your aunt? And I'm like, yeah, my fucking... They're like, what language is that? I'm like, I thought it was English. Apparently, it's Spanish. I had no idea until, like, fifth grade in fucking reading class.
After they had us in those streets talking about Titi.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, what the actual fuck are they talking about?
I got so mad. I was like, yo, fuck all you mother... Like, come on, you talking about your aunt? Yeah, fuck you. Why don't you be fucking cultured, okay?
I know.
Oh, fucking hate white people.
Kidding. I love them.
We love them. We love them all. Half white. Oh, my God.
Oh, Lord.
Jesus. Speaking of wild white people, this is a good segue.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Well, so, wait, we're talking about the seasons.
Wait, no. I want
to
segue
into
this.
I don't know if I could go to Florida because of the crazy white people out there.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
Do you ever play the game where you type in Florida man and then
and
your
then it's
day?
Everything.
No, Florida man and then your birthday. And they, it's like, that's a game people play. They do Florida man and then you type in your birthday. And it's, you know, endless amounts of man eats face, alligator eats baby, then father eats alligator. It's like, it's wild, you know? Speaking about wild white people, you know, I watched a show called The Vow, and I've been telling you to watch it, right? And I know you haven't watched it, which is fine, but here's, speaking of crazy whites, you know? Because you have some good whites, you have some crazy whites, which is fine. Not you, everyone's great. But, you know, when you watch these documentaries about, you know, cults and stuff like that, it's always like, oh, like, you know, in the late 80s or the early 90s, it's like, wow, they were crazy back then, you know what I mean? The Vow was literally like 2 years ago. It's like, we're in the information age, like, everyone's supposed to be being so smart, everyone's so smart, and we're so advanced. How are you motherfuckers still, to this day, getting enthralled in sex cults? How? Like, everyone has seen the documentaries about cults. Why are you still getting involved in cults?
I don't think everyone.
But how? If anyone ever approaches...
Did you watch your videos of cults?
Documentaries on YouTube or... Probably like 15, 16, 17, 18.
You watch them on
Netflix? it was like a big thing coming out. It's like, oh, like this comes out, like about that. Why is it still happening?
You didn't even have Netflix when you were 15.
No, but I'm just saying, it was a big thing. You knew about it, like Scientology.
No, you didn't though.
But
that's
I was 19. The people getting enthralled in this are grown adults. So it's called The Vow, and it's about Nexium. And it's just like, okay. I get that, okay, you know, this might be controversial, we might have to cut it, but, like, I understand if you have mental, you know, disabilities, that you could maybe get wrapped up in something like this. But there's normal people. If someone ever approaches you going, hi, ready? This is their pitch. Hi, do you want to change your life? And then they go, you know, no, a normal person will go, get the fuck away from me. I mean, like, you're in a mall, right? You're in a mall. Hey. Can I stop you for a second?
Do you
want to change your life?
Normal?
A normal response would be like, get the fuck away from me. Stop. Some people go, yeah, I do want to change my life. And they go, well, here, I have a plan for you. And it's just like, what the fuck is happening? There is no magic pill. Just stop with the cults. There is no magic. Do you want to better your life? Because we have the plan for you. For $16.95 a week, it's like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Stop. Stop with the cults. Enough. But then it gets me so aggravated. Grown adults who we're supposed to respect.
No, you're not.
Some of these people are parents. It's like, oh my God.
You're not supposed to respect anybody. I really feel like respect is earned.
And then you find out these people are moving to go, and then their daughters are leaving, and they're like, no, it's fine. Like, I fuck you, daughter. Like, I'm staying with some guy named Henry. You know what I mean? It's not even like they're not even pretending to be a religion. It's just some guy with long hair who's ugly that wears glasses. And they go, oh, he speaks 17 languages and he never shits and he has 18 holes in one. It's like, what? It's like, get a grip on reality. Stop this. Maybe you're unhappy because you're the type of person who thinks someone else can make them happy. Maybe that's why you're unhappy. And they have these shawls, like it's like the Taekwondo. And every so often you have to pay for class and you get a stripe on your shawl. And another stripe, it's like, oh, now I'm a teacher. It's like, you have issues. Okay, you need to be in a mental institution. You need a straitjacket. You know, I have, it's every week, so I haven't got, but, you know, spoiler alert, it doesn't end good, and people get raped. Okay? Spoiler alert. They brand themselves like with a cauterizing wire. Adults, 30-year-olds, 20-year-old women. It's like,
you are weird.
Here's the PSA. If someone comes up to you and says, "Do you want to change your life?" Spit on them and run. Because enough with the cults. Enough.
It's true.
Nothing's real. It's all fake. It's beautiful. That's the motto of the podcast. Everyone stop with the cults. Okay, maybe you were dumb in the 70s and 80s with the Bhagwan. It's 2020. Can we stop?
Yeah, we gotta move on.
This is why the aliens don't even want to bother with us. They look down, they go, they're following some guy named Henry?
Trash.
Who scored a 13-12 on his SATs? They're following this guy? Is he some sort of... Like, what are we doing here? It just makes me so mad, you know?
It's gonna be alright.
It is gonna be alright. And that's the thing. And it's gonna be alright because you wanna know why?
Why?
Because the seasons have turned. Football is here. Apple cider donuts are coming.
Well, I don't want to do something.
Spiked cider's coming.
I want to go get pumpkins. And
candy corn? Who doesn't like candy corn?
Me.
You don't like candy corn?
No.
Well, you need to be excited.
I always need it every year for my turkey bowls that I like to make. They're like cake pops. But
right.
When I'm telling you, nothing works better than the candy corn as their fins. When you take
nothing also will give you diabetes like faster than candy corn as well.
Right.
It's, you know what I used to do? You know what I do? I bite the white tip. Then I bite the yellow, and then I save the end.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah. It's like when I get chicken nuggets, you eat the whole breading around it, and then you eat it. Oh. Depends on how hungry I am.
You're nuts.
Yeah. Where are we with time, you think?
No idea.
Who knows? It could be 30 minutes because we had to restart so many times, but it doesn't matter. Well, no, it doesn't matter because we brought the energy, and that was a great story. Ruth Bader Ginsburg is dead. Our aunt is currently banging, probably right now, Amanda's ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
The Vow, you need to watch it. It's on HBO.
I have to get it. The
and
Vow.
I think JonAnthony is winning his fantasy football game today.
Yeah.
And my bets are looking good.
I am going to hire you to hang out with my son and do homework with my son.
Right. I'm a tutor.
Yeah. That's going to be a lot of fun because my kid needs to get his life.
Yeah.
He tells my his teacher...
I mean,
about the coloring bit, I get a letter home.
God.
It's not really a letter; it's a little post-it on the coloring.
It's like a progress report.
No, post-it.
Ooh.
On it.
Personal.
Says, Michael had difficulty completing his task today. Completing his assignment today. He told me he doesn't like to color. So now I'm on 1,000. Because why exactly are you telling your teacher that you don't like to fucking color?
Right.
So I get on the kid app and I'm like, hey, I'm sorry that we had to talk this way and it wasn't more positive, but like saw the notes. So sorry he would give you a hard time. Love to chat.
Yeah.
Dot, dot, dot. So she's like, what's your number? I could call you now. I'm like, okay, sure. And I send it to her. So the teacher calls me and she's like, listen, you know, he was doing the coloring assignment and he told me, you know, coloring's just really not my thing. What? Michael, you can't tell the teacher.
Ah, 5-year-old.
You can't tell the teacher that coloring really isn't your thing. Like, no, that is the thing that you're doing in kindergarten, so it needs to be your thing.
Listen, teach. Coloring is just really not my thing, so why don't you fucking cool it?
No, literally. So he came home, and I made him finish the packet, and we sent it back. So she also said to me, she's like, I'm also going to move his seat because he's in the back of the classroom. And she goes... So every kid that's going to wash their hands, use the bathroom, or passing them, and he's talking. She goes, he's very distracted by that.
Ooh.
I said, yeah, and I said that. I said, when I saw when he was in the back of the classroom, I saw a picture of him in the background. He had his hands in his pocket, and he was sitting like this. I'm like, who does this fucking kid think he is? He's got his hands in his pocket. He's just maxed and relaxed. I go, look at him in the back.
Cool.
I go, look at him in
but
the back.
But was he sitting playing b-ball outside of the school?
I go, look at him in the back row. Like, he don't even give a fuck. He's like, what up? I'm like, no. So when she said that, I was like, no, I agree. I didn't want to be that parent that asked for that. But the fact that you're saying that, I'm in complete agreement with it. And she was like, and I guess he knows so-and-so from his from pre-K at the daycare.
The
and
girl,
like,
right?
Yep. Oh, all day. Hey. All day he's calling for
That's my guy.
I go, listen.
He needs to plant seeds early.
But he also needs to fall in line and realize that society and the world has a lot of stipulations and we have boundaries.
Okay, but the fact of the matter is that teacher who's like, oh, Michael isn't coloring the lines, is probably snorting gator tails on the weekend.
No, she didn't care. No, she probably doesn't care.
No, but okay, that's fine.
She was just like, he's getting distracted.
But who are you to judge? You fucking piece of shit.
No, he should be filling out the, because Michael goes, oh, well, I'm not coloring that because that's a tooth and that's white. What color am I going to make it? I go, well, color it with white, Michael. He goes, you can't see if you color it with white. It's the same thing. The paper's already white. Why would you color it with white, Mommy? This doesn't make any sense. It's already white, and I'm leaving it like that. That's his case. He's so, it's already white. He's telling me, oh, you still have to take the crayon with the white and go refuse
it. I know I told you this. I know I told you this, but for the listeners. So at this story takes place a few months ago when the baby was four, right? So, you know, I'm being my normal self, loud, being an asshole around the house, just yelling.
Oh, yeah.
Just yelling, this is that. The baby's over, whatever. We're listening to Jonas Brothers. But, you know, I'm around the house yelling, whatever. Being my normal, annoying self. So I'm sitting there, ba ba da ba. The baby comes up to me. Four-year-old. Comes up to me. He looks at me. He goes, can you... Literally, hand motion, everything. I'm not even, like, adding. He goes, can you stop with the nonsense already? And I laugh, and I go, nonsense? I was like, you don't even know what that means. And he goes, yeah, nonsense. Like the words coming out of your mouth? Nonsense. And just walks away. Like, who the fuck do you think you are, motherfucker?
He's good like that.
The word nonsense at four, and then perfectly describe it, and then walk off like mic drop?
He's good like that.
Fucker?
He's good like that. But he does scream on the top of it. He'll be in the bedroom, laugh! And I'm like, why is he actually doing that? And I think it's because I was here. I lived here when I was pregnant, and you would constantly scream on the top of your.
I would just scream.
And then when he was a baby, you would always just scream on the top of your.
I would yell at
his
face.
So now he's. Yeah. It's so fucking obnoxious. I want to kill myself. He's like, la. I'm like, why are you yelling so loud? What is that? Are you okay? And then I'm like, oh, because JonAnthony does it. I don't know. Just blurt out whatever it is.
Yeah, we got to wrap here.
All right.
Listen, guys, appreciate you guys coming with us again on another wild ride, another episode of the What Goes On podcast. We really, really do appreciate you. Like, subscribe, share, follow, watch, listen.
All of it.
Show your mother, your grandmother, show your fucking stupid stepmom.
Anything
who's a
you want
bitch.
Us to talk about, you can
show your mother
us.
With the fake titties. You
need
know?
Advice? We take advice now.
Show your hot sister.
Like he does every time that we meet.
You know what I mean? If you got a sister out there, my number is 631-882-5413. That is accurate. Anyway, you want to leave with us anything?
UNITY. Unity? UNITY.
Bye.
Okay, no. Bye.
Beautiful.
This the way it is. Fade away three and I makes it in. Break your ankles cause your paper's thin. Money sign, that's what baby paper is. I don't care about that though. Daddy gotta go down low. Got a new single, go down low. Been working so hard and I